Hey there, StarCraft fans. It's Falco Paladin coming at ya with yet another edition of StarCraft Brood War Remastered. Today on Destination, it's going to be Zhongbi versus Firebat Hero here on, again, Destination topside. We've got ourselves a red Terran. It is Firebat Hero. And in the bottom side, it is a teal Protoss. It is Zhongbi, according to the replay name on a replay pack that I got off of Team Liquid. We'll have to see if these measure up to the names, but I figure that maybe it's worth a shot. Okay, so this is going to be a Patreon cast for the week of March the 4th or so. So if you're watching this the first week of March, thank you very much for being subscribed to me on patreon.com/falconpaladin for at least $1 a month. I really do appreciate it. It gives you the right to watch this 1 month before the people on YouTube. And if you hear this on YouTube or watch this on YouTube, hit the like button, hit the subscribe. I'm here 5 times a week with Brood War content. And let's see who's going to come out on top here in this PBT here on Destination. I do associate Destination with foreigner players, but it was a ladder map for a very, very long time, so Koreans played on it too. Not entirely sure why. Maybe I have more replays with foreigners on this map than, Korean players. Anyway, 345 APM on average here from Zhongbi. We got 200 plus here for Firebat Hero. I don't have very many games from Firebat Hero, so let's go ahead and see if this is him. Boom, boom. Gateway, barracks coming up, nothing too weird. You can check out Falcon Paladin gear at falconpaladin.store. You can get hats and hoodies and mugs and t-shirts and all sorts of cool stuff, honestly. You want to Terry the Overlord mug? You can check it out. falconpaladin.store. Probably. Planning on that. I'm not sure if it's up there yet, but if it's not there, it's coming soon. Pro harassment, ancient, been going on since 1998 when the game came out. You know, just a full 24 years ago now. Good grief. Good grief. The 20-year anniversary of Brood War was 4 years ago now? You've got to be kidding me. Time, where does it go? Where is it taking all of us? Someplace good, I hope. Maybe. Cybercore on the way from Zhongbi. And where's your factory? There's your factory. Factory coming up from Firebat. Oh, APM creeping up to 350 now. Then he's got something to do. He's got a probe to chase. He's got a marine to micro. He's got stuff to build and buildings to relocate and walling the probe in here so it can't escape. Sick move, by the way. And, the marine got caught up. Marine, take a shortcut through here. There we go. Gets a shot off down here. Oh, another hit. That's big. This poor probe. On the other side, Singularity Charge begins, and the probe does. Can't escape. Walled in. And is murdered. Excellent. Well done there by Firebat Hero. APM creeping up to 400. So, yeah, this very well could be. The APMs are feeling high enough now. Maybe Firebat's a player who doesn't spam early. And instead, he is someone that uses the APM when he needs to. And that is getting into this point now. 6 hits from a Dragoon to kill an SCV. It takes a while, but good scout for the SCV. SCV dies anyway, as per usual. Second factory on the way. Machine shop coming up. What's the first upgrade of choice by Firebat Hero? Well, it could be anything. It could be Vulture Speed. It could be Spider Mines. It could be Siege Mode. These are options. Oh, look at this. Actually, he's mining out these minerals for this back ramp of his. That is intriguing. I haven't seen someone do this intentionally. I mean, the first 5 minutes. Possibly ever. What is the plan here exactly? I mean, generally, you just want to take a base, get some tanks on these bridges, and call it a day. But Dragoon pressure is going to be real, I guess. And Spider-Mine's on the way, siege tank in production. Marines holding the top of the ramp. No bunker. And this is where the Dragoon's like, where's your second base? I don't know, man. Marines? Oh, that's so bad. Yeah, see, you can't see up there. You got to get up the ramp right in the face. And look at how dangerous, look how scary it is. You're like, I don't know what's up there. There were 3 Marines last time I checked, but what if there's 4 now? Pack it out. Back it out. Deny. Deny the expansion while expanding myself, maybe? Nope. Second gateway coming in. Ooh, robotics facility coming in. Worried about those spider mines. I have to imagine this is going to be an observatory, and it is. Quick observatory coming in from Zhongbi down south. All right, fine. Dragoons hanging out. Animation. Like, the idle animation for Dragoons is possibly the best in the game, isn't it? Like that little rotating thing on the bottom. I don't know what that's for exactly. It's help generating energy for the, I don't know, the gun at the top to shoot or whatever it is that shoots energy balls or whatevs. What's it actually called? A phase disruptor. Yeah, okay, that's technobabble, but whatever. Science fiction, man. It's there. So there's the expansion for the Protoss. Again, you want to have more bases than your Terran opponent. And it's really just not interested in going up there at all. Hey, surprise! Two siege tanks are out. There's Marines here, too. And I don't know. I don't think you want to go in there necessarily, do ya? Do ya? Yeah, mine this out for no reason. He hasn't really gone back there or anything. I don't know. Maybe he has. Oh, he snuck vultures out that way. He totally did go back there. All right. I support this. Throwing spider mines down in places where you don't expect them to be. The observer see that? No, doesn't see the spider mine. And then, yeah, just spider mines up, killing a probe, getting out of there, having a good day. This is awesome. This is great from Firebat Hero. Over 400 APM right now, playing fast. Again, now that he has stuff to do. Oh, man, this little push could be pretty damaging. Marines and siege tanks are good. Trying to get free hits off. Oh, weakening the Dragoons quite nicely, vultures are, without actually dying. Managed to escape with all of 5 HP on that vulture. That's insane. Absolutely insane. Here we go again. Vultures. Oh, they prevent the Dragoons from escaping. They lop off that avenue of retreat. Just sick stuff. And suddenly, Zhang Bi's in an immense amount of trouble. This early push is intense. Oh, man. Is he going to just completely shut down the natural base of the Protoss with this one base push? Zhang Bi should have seen this coming. He recognized there wasn't an expansion on the ground. I mean, not that that necessarily is enough, but... Oh, get out of here. Get out of here. Dragoons, they take down one siege tank. Dragoons, they don't know if they want to fire on the spider mines or what here. Trying to stay out of... This is some sick micro. Staying out of range of the spider mines, but the siege tanks have siege mode now. And the Dragoons are in all of the trouble. And there's a repair. Oh, friendly spider mine splash almost kills this siege tank, but it doesn't. It doesn't, though. This is really good stuff from both of these players. The natural base, can we save it? Oh, spider mine. Oh, coming down this ramp is so crappy. It sucks so much for Zhang Bi right now. No, friend, no, why? Oh, this is bad. Losing your second base as a Protoss is really terrible. Expanding. Happily expanding is Firebat Hero. Like, that's right. That's what I thought. Turret up to chase the observer away so it can't provide as much detection for spider mines that are all over the natural base of Zhang Bi right now. Disgusting plays. Disgusting play. Dude, this is Firebat Hero versus Zhang Bi. I know. I can't read this. Maybe somebody else can. Maybe somebody who speaks Korean can read this and tell us what it says, but... This is incredible play. Finally clears out the Terran influence. Can't re-expand, doesn't have enough money for that. Just so behind on second base construction here. Meanwhile, Vultures, I don't... Oh, what did you think this would be open, guys? What are you doing? Well, might as well check it, says Firebat Hero. No harm, no foul. There's a Reaver on the way, so maybe attempting some kind of a Reaver drop to catch back up here. 30 to 28 workers. Second base is effectively done here for Firebat Hero. And the Nexus, second Nexus, just restarting again for Zhang Bi here at 8.5 minutes. So, brrr. Firebat Hero go brrr. How do you make that sound? It's B-R-R-R-R-R-R. But, like, if you're saying it, is it brrr? I bet it's brrr. Firebat Hero go brrr. That's the sound. Saw a Reddit post about the A-10 Warthog tank killer. Which I've always loved, because there was a video game that came out in like 97 or like 96 about the A-10 tank killer. And I always just loved the concept of an airplane that was capable of killing tanks. And there are definitely proponents of the tank killer and Warthog and people that hate it and think it's not good. And wasn't even good back in the day, and it's definitely not worth anything today. But, you know, if you got a bunch of undefended tanks rolling around, like in a certain unnamed conflict going on right now, maybe the tank killer is the way to go. That's a thought. Probably not, though. It's just old. There was a video game being made about it when Brood War wasn't around yet. So, I mean, that's how old this concept is. That's how old this plane is. But trying to get a third base up. I like this play from Zhang Bi. Like, I gotta make this up somehow. Vultures... Trying to win this fight, getting the probe at least, and then maybe trying to escape. Nice body block, though. Beautiful body block. Reaver shenanigans. Sharking around. There are siege tanks covering this entire... Is there a bat covering back there, too? Yes. A couple SCVs go down. Not that many, I don't believe. Still 38. The 32 on the Firebat worker count in the top right there. Sneaking around. Man, backing out. Junk Bee's like, I don't like it. Too many siege tanks around. Too much siege mode around. Kill a spider mine, which is super, super cool, I guess. Is there an observer? Oh, there is an observer here. Okay. Don't kill the Ursidon, especially not with a Reaver. That costs money. If you're going to kill fuzzy animals that are on the map, at least don't use Reaver shots you have to buy. Right? Scarabs aren't free. Bit of a push here from Zhang Bi. 78 to 75 total supply. Oh my gosh, he did it. Wow. Zhang Bi's like, all right, Falcon, I got you. Bam. Ursidon kill. Brutal. Absolute brutality. I'm going to root against Zhang Bi now for killing that defenseless animal for no gosh darn reason at all. Siege tanks up. That is a lot of siege tanks now, though. Spider-Mine's in the front. Vulture's in the front. It's just Dragoons here. No Zealots at all. Are we making Zealots today? Production tab says we're getting a Citadel of a Dune. So maybe. Maybe yes. Where did that shuttle go, actually, by the way? Oh, it's up here. It's up here doing some stuff. Killing vultures and whatnot. Super rad, killing another SCV. And then the pickup. Oh, so good from Zhang Bi here. I'm telling you, these players are sick. SCV's going back to work. Zhang Bi's clawing his way back into victory right now. He's got a third base rolling. He's up 3-2 on the Terran. Vultures throwing down spider mines every which way because they're annoying like that. And keeping vultures active is how you win a PvT. Truly, truly is. Finally going to Zealot production a little bit here. By that, I mean making six at a time, which is probably more than just a little bit. Yeah, vultures, if they're trying to shoot through here, there's a Dragoon covering that. Really smart play by Zhang Bi. He knows this map very, very well. That's something that can definitely be a problem. Vultures taking their time on a pylon up this way. 122 to 97 supply. It turns out having three bases allows you to make more stuff than your Terran opponent is. But the trick, as always, is the fact that the tanks are really cost efficient. The spider mines are really cost efficient. Vultures are pretty cost efficient against things like Zealots for sure. Get out of there, vultures. Make a run for it. Oh, they're going to stand and fight way too much. This guy runs for it. There's nowhere to go. This is very much a dead end. You're not going to be able to get out of, but whatever. It's cool. Where did that shuttle go? Did he go back in and die? I wasn't looking at him. Seems entirely possible that's what happened. But also, maybe he went home? Pick up a new Reaver, possibly? Ugh. Alright, well. Doesn't seem well for our Reaver friend, but... Anywho, come in. Okay, that group gets wiped out. This group, again, trading out for siege tanks is fine. If you're killing enough siege tanks and losing all your dragoons in the long run, it's not a bad thing. Zealots on top of the siege tanks, exactly what you want to be seeing here if you're the Protoss. That is the ideal engagement. 93 to 69 supply right now. Hot dang, Zhang Bi. Still 400 plus APM for Firebat Hero. Doesn't have a third base. This is a bit of an older replay where the concept of a third base for Terran wasn't considered as vital as it is today. But you know, that's why we like to watch the old matches in the remastered. Kind of sometimes to show us how far we've come, you know? At least fourth base is hard to take on this map. Third base, not as hard, especially if you expand over here. Cover this bridge with tanks. It's really not that bad. Senior Firebat Hero, but he's at 36, 37 total workers here compared to a full 49 for the Protoss. Pushing up. Oh, here's the shuttle. I found it. It's been dropping Zealots. I guess the Reaver might have gotten wiped out by a siege tank, but there's still some Zealot bomb. That action that just happened there. Tank count getting wiped out once more. I mean, by wiped out, I mean, there's still five here. Six on the field. He's doing a really good job with this and taking that fourth base, the all-important fourth base, over on the left side of the 9 o'clock position now is Zhang Bi. He's up 102 to 83 supply, and he's really flipped this game on its head. Zhang Bi was in trouble. His second base got wiped out. He really gambled to get a third base up, got it, and that's what's paid off for him in the long run. Firebat Hero is not able to deny him. unfortunately for Firebat, to deny that third base, and that's, again, really just slowly overcome him quite nicely. Trying to set up and get rid of this third base that we were just talking about here as Firebat Hero, but a bunch of Dragoons come in, siege mode up, and I don't think you can afford to retreat from this location. I really don't, but you kind of have to. Eventually, it comes out, too many hits from Siege Tanks, too many Spider Mines in your face. Backs out, waits for reinforcement, Siege Tank count high, but is it too high? Is the question. Production tab says Vulture, Siege Tanks. On the other end, a Stargate and a Temple Archives on the way. And these Vultures are overextending a little bit. They need to pull back and make sure these Zealots all die. There you go. Pulling backs. Zealots not really getting on top of the tanks as much as they want to. Oh, but now they are. Now they are. And suddenly, tank count getting wiped out. And suddenly, Zhongbi up 101 to 66 supply. Beautiful Zealot play. Firebat Hero did not keep his Vultures alive for that very eventuality until it was too late. He was too aggressive with them. And suddenly, I think Zhongbi's in full control of the match after that engagement. Zealots, once again, Dragon Spider Mines onto enemy siege tanks. Yeah, they'll do that. They'll hit them with their own Psy Blades as necessary. Scantid absorbing the battle, hoping he doesn't get shot in the face by these Dragoons. No upgrades at all for the Gateway units. Actually, no upgrades at either for the Terran. That's kind of how you know it's getting a bit of an older game. But both players playing extremely well. Zhongbi just has the upper hand. 83 to 61 total supply. Yes, that's where you want to be. And especially if you've killed a whole ton of siege tanks to get there, right? If that's the difference, but there are still 17 siege tanks on the field, you're not doing very well. But if you're killing siege tanks, and sure, the enemy is mostly vultures, and maybe mostly SCVs, then sure, you're doing just fine. Doing all right. Four basing to this, once again, two basing Firebat Hero. He needs a third more than anything else, but I just don't know that he feels safe enough to do that. He's very active with the vultures, obviously, coming down this left side. And that's it. Firebat Hero taps out. It's 17 minutes and 30 seconds. He says, okay, that base is fully saturated. You've probably got 20 more workers than I do. And my siege tank count is like 3. So that's not going to happen. Beautiful game from Zhongbi, a lesser Protoss. After losing their natural base to Firebat Hero like that, would have absolutely not been able to come back and win. But he reestablishes the base, has enough Dragoons to handle both the tanks and the Spider Mines and the Vultures. And then it's just pretty aggressive. A little bit of some Reaver harass, killing some SCVs, attacking into Siege Tanks when he feels like he can wipe out Siege Tanks without losing too much on the other end. And just beautiful, beautiful Protoss play from Zhongbi. That's just kind of the player that he is. He ends up with, again, no upgrades. None. No upgrades for either player, which I think is insane. But once again, older replay. The Blues from 2008, 2009 or so. 1.16 was the patch. Amazing. Zealots, Dragoons, an Arbiter's in production. He's working on that. He is working on plus one ground weapons. But it's a bit far away from completion here. Imagine if those tanks had plus one or plus two at 17 minutes, which is entirely possible. I think those engagements would have gone much better for Firebat Hero, but not something that maybe players were as aware of back then. What was the importance of upgrades, even in the first 15, 16, 17 minutes of the match, you know? So absolutely fantastic play. I love that play, too. Remember when Firebat Hero mined out that top ramp to send vultures around the backside and get out of the Dragoon contain that was set up down here, and then that started that whole engagement that allowed Firebat Hero to take down the natural base. So super sick opening. Zhongbi took the damage, overcame the damage, gambled to take a third base fast, paid off, got some vulture harass, threw up some pylon to defend against that, got the fourth base up with pretty much no trouble. And once he's on four bases, 202 basing Terran, Firebat Hero not really... I really think Firebat Hero would have benefited from getting a third base and defending it with the army that he had, rather than trying to come down here and take this base down. It exposed him. It set him up for flank attacks from Dragoons and whatnot. Turtling up on three bases would have probably been a better bet for him. And just using the Vultures to run around and cause issues would have been the better play. But, you know, Firebat Hero, much, much better player than I am in every possible way. So who am I to give him advice? I don't know. 84,000 points there for Zhongbi, 73,000 points on the other hand. 24. Firebat, hero, both players ended up, well, you know, more killed by the Protoss here. A lot of Vultures went down, a lot of Zealots and Dragoons, but definitely more on the Terran side. Falling, 10 Terran buildings dying, only 2 Protoss. Good advantage there for sure. And then resources, that 4-base advantage. It wasn't for very long, but having the 3rd base up as fast as he did helped with this too. 28,000 resources spent for the Protoss, 23,000 for Firebat Hero. More gas mine, more minerals mine, more total spent by a full 5,000 in only 17 minutes, which is a massive advantage and a major reason that Firebat Hero lost this game. So overall, I mean, that was, man, maybe a 10 out of 10 as far as a PVT is concerned. I mean, it could have been longer, obviously. This, I mean, could have been like a 45-minute PVT with recalls and, I mean, tank drops and all sorts of crazy stuff all over the place. But, you know, 17 minutes jam-packed, action-packed PVT is definitely something awesome. So that is going to be it for me today. This has been Falcon Paladin coming at you with yet another edition of StarCraft Brood War Remastered. Go ahead, hit that like button, hit that subscribe. If you like what you saw and what you heard today, you can also catch me on Twitter, Facebook, Patreon, and Twitch, all at /FalconPaladin. And until next time, as always, thank you so much for watching. You take care of yourself.